Good evening, everyone, and welcome. Tonight, we are taking on, well, finishing off, Season 7, Round 4 of the Solo Crisis League. So, Season 7, Round 4 is using Teen Titans as our base set and Crisis 1 as our Crisis expansion. We have three characters to pick from this week, or this round. We have Crisis Wonder Woman, Kid Flash, and Booster Gold. Now, as I've talked about a few other times this season, we're doing a cool little system where you get bonus points depending on the character you picked. Now, Booster Gold, I find to be one of the strongest cards in the game, but also got bonus points this round, somehow. I think it's just because he didn't do very well in some past rounds. So, because of that, Booster Gold is my man today, and he reads, plus one power for each defense card you play during your turn. When you avoid an attack, draw a card. So, when you avoid an attack, it's really only going to happen maybe in these first couple ones if I happen to get a defense early, or when the first appearance attacks from villains takes place. The good news is that we'll get the plus one power for each defense card we play throughout the game. So we're really just going to fill our deck with every defense card we see. And hopefully that means we'll be ready for any given attack and get plus one for all of those defense cards. So it's really a win-win situation. Booster Gold's it's a strong character choice. I would recommend it whenever it's an option. So, with that in mind, let's get started soon. We have Arkham Breakout in play. When a villain with an attack enters the lineup, treat it as if it were a first appearance attack against all players. Each player must secretly place a card from his hand face down and then discard them. Actually, no, I'm sorry. That is for multiplayer. For solo play, I believe it's just discard five cards with different names. But I will double check that just to make sure. It is discard your hand at the beginning of your turn. Remove this crisis if each of those cards has a different name. So yeah, that's the plan. That's what we're shooting for. And then Ra's al Ghul. At the end of your turn, if you did not buy or gain a card from the lineup, add the top card of the main deck to the lineup. So if we buy a kick instead of cards from the lineup, we're going to have to add two cards to the lineup for that turn. So that's going to dwindle the deck faster. It's going to bring out more villains to trigger Arkham Breakout. All sorts of bad news there. So, like I said, we're going into this pretty easily, I think, because Booster Gold's just shooting to get as many defense cards as possible, which hopefully we can use against some of those first appearance attacks we have to deal with. 4, 5 there, and then let's actually get that lineup filled. We have Magic Bracers. That's a cheap and easy defense. That's a really great start. Captain Atom, okay. Strife is an attack we'll have to deal with, but I don't think it really matters. Power of Red can really help early in the game. And Colony Suit. Colony Suit will be good later, but not so much right away. I guess it is still plus two power and it's only two power. Sorry, it's only plus one power. It costs two power. Got it. So Strife's attack triggers. Each foe reveals his hand and discards each card with the same name as a card in the lineup. Well, none of these are in the lineup, so we're good to go there. And we're looking at 1, 2, 3, 4 power. It's a pretty easy choice to say Magic Bracers for the defense against with Booster Gold, and we'll get Colony Suit as well. You never know, we might need it later. Just one card, that's right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Signature Trench Coat is a great card, just don't really need it yet. 1, 2, 3 power. We're going to use that to say goodbye to Strife, and then get ready for this next turn. Shuffle it up, get a new card out here. Demonic Influence. Now, that's an interesting choice. So, Demonic Influence reads plus 2 power and an additional plus 1 power for each villain you control. Now, obviously, in a crisis game, it's really difficult usually to get a villain. I mean, by default, they're destroyed right after you buy them, so that doesn't really bode well for getting them into your deck. But we have Signature Trenchcoat available right away. What that does is allow us to get cards from the destroyed pile. So add that to Demonic Influence's abilities, and you're going to have a pretty good time, I think. So we might use those two in tandem with each other. Try and shoot for filling up a deck with villain cards. So this hand is 5 punches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You know what? I'm going to go for we'll go Demonic Influence. We'll do it. New card comes out. 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, so one, it's a defense card, so that's 2 power, booster gold. 3 power here and all these vulnerabilities. Now, we will buy a kick, but we did not buy a card from the lineup. So that triggers Ra's al Ghul in 2 cards will get added. Ravager, great choice. And Ms. Martian, also a great choice. So that didn't hurt us too bad. Now, Ravager would be better if we could get some of those ongoing cards out here we haven't seen yet. Ms. Martian, though, very strong contender. Able to get really strong hands going. One, two, three, 4 powers, all we have here. I'm thinking Signature Trenchcoat, but I haven't seen any great villains. Maybe we will soon, though. New card coming out. Ooh, another Ms. Martian. Might leave one there, and maybe one for another, for Collapse and Parallel Worlds later. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 power. With 5 power, we're going to get Ravager and Ms. Martian. I want Ravager to work. We just need some ongoing cards. And once that happens, we can say goodbye to starters and stuff. Hawk and Dove, though. That's useful. That reads plus 2 power if 2 copies of the same card are in play, an additional plus 1 power. That means punches, especially early in the game, become extra powerful because they make Hawk and Dove an extra power themselves. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We're going to get ourselves, we'll get Captain Atom here. And then a new card will come on out. Strife attacks. Each foe reveals his hand and discards each card with the same name as a card in the lineup. None of these are in the lineup, so we're good there. 2, 3, 4, and 5. We're just going to use that to get rid of, you know, no, we're going to get Hawk and Dove. Maybe we can get rid of Strife this turn. New card coming out. Another villain, but no attack there. 1, 2, 3. We're going to go 4, 5 to get rid of Lady Vic. I want Lady Vic. I want to get that with Signature Trenchcoat. So we're going to not use its ability, but instead its plus 2 power to get that as soon as possible. All right, so we've got a little deck going. It's nothing powerful, nothing too powerful yet, but we've got a few strong contenders in there. We've got Signature Trenchcoat. We have Ms. Martian. We've got 1 defense card so far, but we're getting there. And soon we're going to start gaining some villains. So a new card coming out. Oh, that's too bad. We're going to start with Ms. Martian. If this is the first card you play this turn, set your hand aside and draw 5 cards. All right, at the end of our turn, put that on top of our deck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. With that 7, goodbye to Strife. We have 4 left over. Power of the Red to, you know, kind of clean up some hands. New card comes out. This goes on top. Come on, we need 5 cards of different names. We have 5 cards of different names. Discard them to end Arkham Breakout. So that's 1 down. Now, since we couldn't buy anything, we have to add 2 cards to the lineup. One of them is an attack, but that doesn't matter as much. Because we beat Arkham Breakout, so that attack doesn't affect us. Captain Atom, you may gain a card of cost 4 or less in the lineup and put it into any player's hand. We're going to take Detonator, put it into our hand, play it, and then I'm going to, we will discard that to destroy a vulnerability in my discard pile. There we go. So, then it's just 1, 2, 3 power. We'll go ahead and get a Quiver of Arrows and stop there. New card coming out. Another Psycho Pirate, huh? So, we got 2 villains. Villains aren't a huge deal when there's just the supervillain out, but I do prefer to clear them out if possible. Let's see what we can do here. I'm pretty much always going to choose Miss Martian, put these aside, and play five cards. It's basically like saying you get a six-card hand, so I see no reason why you wouldn't. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. We'll say goodbye to Psycho Pirate, and we'll gain another kick. I'm going to shoot for getting rid of another Psycho Pirate this turn, and then the following turn get Ra's al Ghul. But, you know, it all depends on how things shuffle out here. We'll get a detonator down. And then it is 1, 2, 3, 4. With that 4, we'll get Geokinesis. I don't really want Geokinesis. I just want Ra's al Ghul to not trigger. I don't want to fill up with even more villains. All right, Ravager comes out, and that triggers Detonator. Or, sorry, it triggered by Detonator to destroy another vulnerability. That's one power. You can gain a card of cost 4 or less. We'll take Solstice. Oh, put it into our hand. I'm sorry. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and draw a card. 5, 6, goodbye to Psycho Pirate, bringing us down to 1 power. Play this, discard this, draw this, look at the top, we may discard it, we will. Alright, that was pretty good. We got rid of the villain we wanted to get rid of. We got a vulnerability off the top of our deck so that Ra's al Ghul will hopefully not be in the way, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. Will not be saved by that vulnerability in my hand, I should say. There we go. Okay. New card coming out. Bumblebee, good choice. All right, Signature Trenchcoat. Let's get a villain. And we're going to get Lady Vic here. Then it is 1, 2, 3, 4 power. We'll use that to go ahead and get Bumblebee. Move on to that next turn. Molecular Vibration. Alright, Ravager is triggered by Detonator to destroy a card. Goodbye to this vulnerability here. That's all three vulnerabilities destroyed, so that is a good start. So that's that. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Do we want to use Detonator? You know, I'm going to also use Detonator to destroy a punch. Don't really have to. I just see a really good opportunity there to start building that stuff up. So we'll use that 6 to get Molecular Vibration. As I said earlier, I think I'm going to leave Miss Martian for a Collapsing Parallel Worlds. That's a card I definitely like to have on the other side of that. Daughter of Trigon. Good choice. Miss Martian's out, so we know what we do there. It's 1 power. Look at the top card of our deck. We may discard it. We'll leave it there. We'll play this. Discard Colony Suit. Draw a card. And we are at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Cassie Sandspark it is. And we go on to that next turn. Still just a little shy where I want to be. I'm a little behind schedule if I'm kind of timing it in my head. Haven't seen the defense cards we want to see. Defense cards will make Booster Gold work. In solo, you want to play them often, not just have them available to you. So we need to have one per hand. We've only seen one defense card this entire game. So we're going to have to try and fix that. Oh, I guess there was no need to shuffle that. We have 5 cards here. All right, Captain Atom will use to get Molecular Vibration. Then it's just 2, 4, 6, 7. Daughter of Trigon. Great choice. Cinderblock. We have a villain again. Now, Cinderblock does not have to be beat. The good thing about Cinderblock is he does synergize well with Booster Gold. So he reads, draw a card, and you put a defense card from your discard pile on top of your deck. Guaranteeing a defense card in your next turn helps Booster Gold use his ability more often. Now, to get that, we'll have to obviously beat him and then purchase him back with a signature trench coat, but that is okay. I think that is totally doable. Get Detonator out here. And that's a case of 2, 3. Get rid of that. Use this to gain him back. And then one power here. That's fine by me. Gotta get some real power generation going. So let's figure that out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We'll play this just to see what we get. 6. We'll get T-Wing and stop there, I suppose. It's all we can do. It's not like we have many other choices. Magic Bracers helps, though. All right, this is good. So Bumblebee can come on out. So can Molecular by Vibration. That's a few ongoing effects we have available to us now. And then it goes Magic Bracers. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Pay one less to defeat villains for and supervillains for each card type you have in play. So that's 1, 2, 3 card types. So he'd be 6, but we only have 1, 2, 3, 4 power. Oh well, we can get Magic Bracers at least. Oh wait, you know what? We have 4 power, and we can discard this to draw a card. Look at the top card. We'll leave that there. We'll use Detonator to destroy a card. That's what we'll do. It's got to be a punch in here we don't want, right? Yeah. Yeah. We'll leave Bumblebee there. We still buy Magic Bracers like I suggested earlier. I was trying to see if maybe we could make something else happen, but didn't go the way I wanted. Oh well. New card coming out. Mammoth is a defense card, but a villain. So, Ravager comes out. Because of Bumblebee, we can destroy a card. Good thing seeing all these go really fast. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and draw a card. We'll get Molecular Vibration on the board. 6, 7. Let's discard Molecular Vibration to draw a card. 8, discard Bumblebee here to get to 9 so we can beat Ra's al Ghul. Now, I would say, let's just beat Mammoth and do that next turn. But honestly, Ra's al Ghul lasted a lot longer than I wanted him to. Normally, I would have had him beat a while ago, I feel like. At least I feel that way. I could be wrong. It might just be me overestimating Booster Gold's ability. But in my head, that should have gone a lot faster. So we're going to go ahead and beat Booster Gold. Hopefully get one of those defense cards in our hand and figure out what this next crisis is we're going to deal with. So, our hand here has no defense cards. We're going to have to see whatever happens. Our new villain is Untouchable Villain. At the start of your turn, put the top card of the main deck into the lineup. If it's not a villain, discard a card. You must destroy 8 cost worth of cards in your hand. Alright. To beat it, we have to destroy 8 costs in our hand. So, Captain Cold. Each player flips the superhero face down. When the villain is defeated, each player may discard a random card. If you do, flip your superhero face up. All right, new card comes out for our turn. Ooh, another Mammoth. New card for the Crisis. It is a villain, so Untouchable Villain remains in play, I guess. Lady Vic can come on out. And then Demonic Influence gets 1, 2, 3, 4 and draw a card. Sure, we'll play this, discard these 2. 5. And then we can, you know what, we'll use that to buy Mammoth. And then use this to get Mammoth from the destroyed pile. Hopefully that pays off. We'll see if it does. New card comes out for the turn. And then one for the Crisis, which is a villain, so we're still good on that. We can get this ongoing card out here. Quiver of Arrows. Let's look at this. We will leave that there. Draw a card. You may put a defense card from your discard pile on top of your deck. Normally, I'd be all over that. Oh, wait. We will, actually. We'll put Mammoth on top of our deck. And then it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We'll use that 5. Just thinking. Let's draw a card. 6, 7. And we'll use that to get rid of both of these villains. So we get rid of two villains in one turn. That's a better plan, I think. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. New card for the turn. New card for the crisis. Not a villain. Discard a card. So, okay, so we get to choose it. It doesn't say a random card. We get to choose it. We're going to put Punch down. We have a new ongoing here. Bunch of new ongoing cards. We're going to play, not yet, but play this for 1, 2, 3 power. Discard this to destroy a card in my discard pile. We're just going to keep going with that system because it's working. We still only have 3 power. We're going to discard this to get to 4, 5, saying goodbye to Mammoth. All right, come on. New card comes out. Then a card for the crisis. It is a villain, so I guess we're okay. 1, because of these guys, we can destroy a card. There's got to be punches or more punches than that one. There we go. That is 1. We can gain a card. We'll gain plasmas here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Goodbye to Sons of Trigon. And we'll stop there, and then hopefully this next turn we're not hit by anything, and we can go ahead and end Untouchable Villain, because we've destroyed a lot. We've destroyed a lot of the starter cards. Almost all of them, I think. So we're really getting a stronger deck going, and hopefully that means Untouchable Villain will be quicker to defeat. Alright, so a new card for the turn. New card for the crisis. Not a villain, so we have to discard a card. We'll discard Punch. And to beat this, we have to destroy 8 costs worth of cards in our hand. I'm not willing to get rid of Daughter of Trigon, so I will play Molecular... No, hold on. We'll play Miss Martian. You may put these cards aside and draw 5 new cards. Now we should be able to get 8 costs here. What do we got? Yeah, we can. We're going to play Mammoth and Molecular Vibration. They're gone. We'll do Mammoth and Cinderblock, actually. No. What to do? Gotta give something. You know, we're going to give Demonic Influence and Molecular Vibration. Keep these two. That will end Untouchable Villain. That crisis is defeated. We're at 1 power. We can get a card of cost 4 or less from the lineup and put it into our hand. We'll take House of Mystery. Put that down. Still at just 1 power. 2, 3, draw a card. 4, and destroy this Punch over here. With our 4, we'll get an Animal Man. We are in a good place now to beat Captain Cold pretty quickly. New card comes out. Let's get a card from the destroyed pile. Oh, what's it going to be? Probably Mammoth if he's here. Do we destroy a Mammoth? There we go. And then it's 2. Oh, wait, that... Oh, no, it doesn't. 2, 3, and draw a card. 4, 5, triggers House of Mystery to draw a card. 6, 7, 8, 9, and we'll discard Bumblebee to get to 10, defeating Captain Cold. All right, here we go. Get our hand ready. We have to discard a random card in order to get our hero back, so we'll discard that one. And let's see what we got. We have no defense cards again. Our new crisis is Atlantis attacks. At the start of your turn, resolve all villain attacks in the lineup against you. If there are no attacks, add the top card of the main deck to the lineup. Each player must discard three non-starter cards, each with different card types. Three non-starter cards, each with different card types. That is in my hand, so as long as we survive this, we should be okay. Lex Luthor. This attack cannot be avoided. Each player gains X weaknesses where X is equal to the highest VP among cards in his hand. That is just one weakness. Perfect. New card adds to the lineup. All right. So each player must discard three non-starter cards, each of different card types. This one have a different one at all? It does not. So it's just discard. So these three cards are discarded, and Atlantis attacks is over. Oh wait, wasn't there something else though? There are no attacks. Add the top card of the main deck to the lineup. So we were supposed to add a card. Still no villain though, so we're okay. We'll play a punch. I don't really need Quiver of Arrows, so I guess we're good. We're good. We're good. What's this? Oh, these are supposed to be on top of my deck, weren't they? I think I might have missed that. Oh well. Might have missed that. Sorry about that. All right, new card coming out. Let's start with Quiver of Arrows to look at the top card of our deck. We may discard it. It is Power of the Red. Yeah, we'll discard that. Then we'll do Colony Suit and Cassie Sands Mark. That'll get us to 1, 2, 3, 4 power. 5, 6, and then one less for each card type. So 7, 8, 9, 10. Just shy. We're gonna discard Molecular Vibration to draw a card. Ooh, we can put this down. You know, I'm just gonna leave that there. Instead of doing anything else, we're gonna get rid of Inertia. And we have 4 power still. Let's go ahead for Animal Man. Let's do it. All right, I was thinking I'd go for Lex Luthor, but I saw the villains in there and thought, you know what, maybe that would be better. So I went for it. Signature Trench Coat we'll start with to get a card from the destroyed pile. Molecular Vibrations on my list. Demonic Influence definitely on my list. Plasmus. Yeah, I mean, these are all pretty good. We're going to go with Demonic Influence. Mammoth here, that's 2 power and triggers House of Mystery to draw a card. 3 power and we can destroy a card. Is there anything we want to destroy? Not really. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and draw a card. 9, 10. Discard Bumblebee to get to 11 and defeat Lex Luthor. So far, so good. Not gonna complain. Things are going okay. Do we have a defense card here? We do. We have a defense card. Perfect. Our new crisis is a death in the family. At the start of your turn, destroy a hero in the lineup, and if there is none to destroy, if there are none to destroy, add the top card of the main deck to the lineup. Each player must destroy a defense card in his hand. So I may not avoid this attack. I may just do what I have to avoid this attack. Do what I have to beat this crisis. So Brainiac, each player discards a random card and then destroys the top X cards of the main deck, where X is equal to the cost of that card. Ooh, that's potentially 6 cards. We're gonna have to defend. We're going to have to defend of this. You may discard this card from your hand to avoid an attack. If you do, put an ongoing card from your discard pile into your hand. All right, what ongoing cards do we have over here? We got Bumblebee. That it. And Molecular Vibration, we'll take Molecular Vibration into our hand. So we're safe there. Death in the Family is going to destroy. Oh, we have to add a card first. So you're going to destroy a hero in the lineup. We're going to say goodbye to Jericho. Whoops. And then go on to this next turn. I don't want to destroy any of the other heroes, though, so let's figure that out. First off, let's use... Oh, what do we got? We can use this to get that one. Sorry, I'm just looking at my options. We're going to take our luck with Miss Martian here to draw five new cards. Hopefully that works out. That's one. Not looking good. Two, three, four, five. That five there is going to trigger House of Mystery to draw a card. Draw a card. And then I may put an equipment or a defense card on top of my deck. That'll be Magic Bracers. We'll play Animal Man. We'll say it's an equipment, which it is. I need to destroy a defense card in my hand. That's going to end a death in the family. All right, this all worked out, actually. And then we're still at what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Put Detonator down. This weakness is not going to help us. 8 we'll use to get Defense Scarab. Or sorry, Reach Scarab. Not defense. It's a defensive card, yeah. That should be better. Okay, that actually worked out better than I was expecting. I thought I was going to get pretty beat up there, but we survived it. All right. So what are we looking at now? A few things. I want to leave Miss Martian for the next for Collapse in Parallel World post that part of the game. John Constantine, we'd like in the deck to start trimming some things down. Magician's Course, it's great for drawing two cards due to House of Mystery. This is also going to be a post-Collapse in Parallel World. So is Cassie Sandsmark. So Geokinesis could go either way. It's just whatever I need it for a crisis. Okay. Let's get our new card out there. Magic. That I definitely want. Molecular Vibration can hit the board. We can get a four or less cost card, but I don't really see one out there I want. So we'll just take the two power instead. Lady Vic can hit the board. 3-4. Let's discard Molecular Vibration to draw a card. Nothing great there. Okay. 5-6-7. We tried. With that, we'll go ahead and get John Constantine. Okay. Didn't go the direction I wanted. Just didn't. All right, 1, 2, 3, and draw a card. Hmm. 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9. 10, 11. 12, 13. Let's say hero. It is. 14, 15. I do not get the 16. I have this weakness here. Nothing else I can really destroy here. Nothing I really want to. You know, we'll discard Lady Vic to get this 14, 15, 16. That will get rid of Killer Frost and Brainiac. Alright, that's a pretty good combination there. Hopefully we get a defense card. We'd had like two in that hand. There's a good chance we are out of luck here, but let's see what we got. Yep, no defense. We're going to see what happens. Our new crisis is Final Countdown. At the start of your turn, put a card with cost 1 or greater from your hand into the lineup. Your team must destroy cards of cost 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, and 2. Alright, so there's some 5s, a 4, and a 3. So we need 7, a 6. I'm going to put that up there. I'd rather have this destroyed. So we need a 2, a 6, and a 7. Okay. And our new villain is Parallax. Each player reveals his hand and discards all cards of cost 3 or less. Unfortunately, it looks like that's going to be the entire hand, isn't it? Yeah, we can't defend, so that's the entire hand discarded. Alright, and then because of Final Countdown, we have to add this to the lineup. And we have to add a card to the lineup also. So there's that. And then next turn, add a card to the lineup. It's another cost 5. And then we have to add a card from our hand. We're going to add Daughters of Trigon because the 7th cost card's pretty rare. Okay. Let's see what we can do. We have 7, 5, 4, and 3. We need 6 and 2. Signature Trenchcoat triggers to get a card from the destroyed pile. Any defensive cards here? No. We'll get Killer Frost. Let's go with this and say superpower is an equipment. Oh, well. All right, so it's just 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're going to discard Detonator to destroy this weakness. With our 6, we're going to buy Magician's Corset. And that should be that. New card comes out. It costs 3. And we have to add a card. Oh, we're going to add Colony Suit here. Costs 2. So now we just need a card there that costs 6. So first up, Miss Martian. Set these cards aside to get 5 new cards drawn. That's really great on crises like this where you have to like discard a card from your hand immediately because now, even though I did that, I still have the ability to get those cards, get that full hand, even a plus one hand, a 6-card hand, because of Miss Martian. So, very useful. So that's 1. You can get a card of cost 4 or less. We're going to get Cybernetic Enhancement. 2 and draw a card. Oh, and because of Captain Atom, that draws another card. Look at the next 2 cards. We're going to draw this one, leave this one here. Still have 1, 2, 3 and draw a card. Use this to discard the punch. Draw another card. Still have 1, 2, 3 power. That's it. 4, 5, 6 and draw a card. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And we get a card from the destroyed pile. From that destroyed pile, we'll take Molecular Vibration. 11's a good amount. We're going to take both copies of Demonic Summoning because we're starting to build up a good collection of 5-cost card, of a villain cost card, villain type cards. Doing that is going to make that even more powerful. So keep it up. New card comes out. It costs 2. And then we have to add a card. Do you have a cost 6 here? We do not. Oh, we did last turn. We could have gotten rid of that. Oh, well. And put this out here. Quiver of Arrows to look at this. We'll leave it there. Mammoth makes us draw a card. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, superpower? No. 6, I can destroy a card. There's a punch, so let's do that. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. With our 8, let's get magic. You know what? No, we'll get Cassie Sandsmark to play a little safer. And we'll get Shapeshift in case we need it later. Probably good on buying cards for a while. New card comes out. Here is a card of cost 6. To end this, we'll destroy a card of cost 7, 6, 5, 4. Unfortunately, Miss Martian. And 2. Yeah, that'll be Colony Suit. There were a few cards there I didn't want to lose, in particular Miss Martian, but you know what? We've already owned one, so we should be okay. That is the end of Final Countdown. So that's the good news there. Here we go. All right. So we have to put a card out, and now we can focus on beating Parallax. We only have 4 cards here. Did I miss something? Must have misdrawn. Cinderblock. We'll save that. We'll put Lady Vic out. 2, 4, 5, 6. Let's say hero. It is not. It's equipment. Can draw a card and put a defense card on top of our deck. Yeah, that's what we want. Okay, so 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Oh, wait, you know what? 11, 12, 13. Yeah, that does it. That's right. That's enough to beat Parallax. Thought maybe I miscounted there, but nope, that did it. We're good. And we set it up so we have a defense card for next turn, so that's also good. Let's see what happens here. Got Mammoth Defendbooth. Let's see what we got. Our new crisis is Dimension Shift. Put the top three cards of the main deck into the lineup. That is one. Oh, there's a flight right now. Two, three, and our fourth one for the turn will be another flight. Of those cards, two of them were flight, which is the perfect defense card for this crisis. Oh well. All cards in the lineup cost two more to buy. Each player to beat, each player needs to reveal the top card of his deck. If any player reveals a card of cost exactly two, remove this crisis. And Deathstroke. Each player destroys a blah blah blah. We'll use defense. You may discard this card from your hand to avoid an attack. If you do, draw two cards. And you may destroy a starter in your hand or discard pile. Now, because we use booster gold, we can actually draw three cards, which is great. Now, before we go any further, we're going to try and beat this crisis. Let's see what we got. Our do you cost two? It does not. Okay. We'll use Captain Atom here, and we're going to use that to get a bunker. We're going to detonate her out on the board. Also Captain Atom triggers to draw a card. Then get Detonator on the board. Get Molecular Vibration on the board. One and draw a card. Two, three, four. Five. Another one of these. Six, seven, eight, nine. And then it's 10, 11, 12, 13 power. So these all cost two. Oh, you know what? We couldn't buy this. We would have had to get one of these. There we go. So we have 13 power still. Use that to get this. That's 9. This will leave us a 3. And we'll stop there. All right. New card comes out. Do I have it? Nope. Okay. We'll put this out. We'll go with Signature Trenchcoat to get a card from the destroyed pile. Something of cost two, if possible. I would really like Miss Martian back, though. Yeah, let's actually go for it. Let's go ahead and get Miss Martian back. All right, 2, 3, 4. We have two copies of that, so that's 5, 6, 7. We'll go ahead and buy Ravager for 4, leaving us with 3. Let's use Molecular Vibration to draw a card. You know, let's not. Hold on. Let's use Dimension Shift. Can we try and beat it? It is cost 2. Each player reveals the top card of his deck. If any player reveals a card of cost exactly 2, remove this crisis. Okay. We beat Dimension Shift. That actually went our way pretty easily. That is not the way that always goes. But it did this time, so that's okay. Still had 3 power left over. We'll use that to buy Bow Staff. Alright, new card comes out. Speed Force, good to see. Start with Cybernetic Enhancement for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 power. Then it's draw a card and put a defense on top of my deck. There it is. Okay. So again, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, I can destroy a card. Just trying to see if there's anything worth destroying in here. I don't think there is yet. You know, we can destroy a flight. We don't need those anymore. And then it's 8, 9, 10, 11 power. And that 11 power is enough to beat Deathstroke, so we're going to do it. Yeah, that's that. We'll go on to this next turn, and we'll get Speed Force soon, hopefully. Oh, and that's right, we set it up so that we have Reach Scarab this turn. So that is also really good news. Awesome. Okay. Our new crisis is Legion of Doom. Put the top three cards in the main deck into the lineup. We'll go a 4, 3 for the card, 1 for the turn. Hero cards lose all attacks and have plus 1 power instead. Each player must destroy a hero in his hand. We'll see what we can do about that. Our new villain is Black Manta. We're going to defend against that. You may discard this card to avoid an attack. If you do, draw 2 cards, and you may put an ongoing card from your discard pile into play. An ongoing card from our discard pile into play, huh? What do we have available over here? We actually might not have one over here. We don't. That might have not been the best defense card, but you know what? That's okay. Also, because we have booster gold, we can draw an additional card. So, heroes lose all attacks and have plus 1 power instead. I think that means we're going to contribute Bumblebee to end Legion of Doom incredibly quickly. That's that. So now it's just Black Manta, who costs 3 more for all equipment in the lineup, which is a lot right now. Quiver of Arrows, look at the top card. We may discard it. We will leave that there. Animal Man, we're just going to say it's an equipment, which it is. We're at 2 power. 3, draw a card, and then because of House of Mystery, draw another card. John Constantine, revealing. So we're at 3 power, revealing 2 cards. Okay. We'll take Demonic Influence. We will, you know, we're going to destroy Ravager. We've got enough of them. We've got enough destruction going now. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and draw another card. 5, 6, 7 because of these two. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and we'll say it's a hero. Ah, it's an equipment. You know, we're actually going to discard Molecular Vibration to draw that equipment. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. That's a lot. For 25, he's going to cost 10 and 3 more for each of these. So that's 13, 16, 19, 22, 25. He costs exactly 25. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's enough. You know, we're just going to beat him. We're just going to beat him. Yeah. He's gone. And we have still a bunch in play. I know the lineup's kind of full, and there's a few things we want there, especially things like Speed Force. I've wanted Magic for quite a while now. But, man, that was a really good opportunity. So we have Mammoth here, Light, and Magic Bracers. So we've got a few options. Depending on what this combination throws at us. Okay, our new crisis is World Domination. At the start of your turn, resolve the current supervillain's first appearance attack against you. If it doesn't have one, discard a random card instead. Each player must destroy the top card of his deck. I think this one... remove this crisis only if each of those cards has cost 1 or greater. And our new villain, the Joker. Each player must put a random card from his hand or discard pile, blah, blah, blah. We're going to actually defend with flight. You may discard this card to avoid an attack. Since we did that, we can draw a card because of booster gold. If you do, you may put a card from your discard pile on top of your deck. So what we're going to do is put something there we want to destroy, like Geokinesis, to end world domination on our terms. Each player must destroy the top card of their deck. Remove this crisis only if each of those cards has a cost of 1 or greater, which is, we know, Geokinesis. Boom, ending world domination. Okay. What to do? Looking at my options, we're going to start with Ms. Martian, as we usually do in this situation, and draw 5 new cards. We might get Joker this turn, and if we don't, there's a lot of good options out there. We're going to use Bunker, reveal the top 3 cards of our deck, put one of each type into our hand, and discard the rest. Okay. Still at 1. 5. 6, 7, 8. 9, 10. 11, because of molecular vibration, we'll draw a card. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. We can get a card of cost 4 or less up there. We're going to go ahead and get Detonator. We're going to get rid of Lady Vic to get the 17, 18, getting Speed Force and getting rid of the Joker. So I really wanted Speed Force. That's what I was trying to do there. I didn't want to end up in a situation where I got another villain and Speed Force was just sitting out there. I wanted both, so I did it. I got rid of the villain there to make it happen. We saw a lot of defense cards get discarded these last few turns. I don't know that we're going to be okay this turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have Magic Bracers and Mammoths, so we are okay. Our new crisis is Kryptonite Meteor. Put the top 3 cards of the main deck into the lineup. As usual, it will be 4. Filling up that lineup. Superpower cards lose all text and have +1 power instead. Each player must destroy a superpower in hand. Our new villain, Atrocitus. Each player puts his hand under his superhero. If you avoid this attack, put a random card from your hand under your superhero. When the villain is defeated, discard those cards. We're going to defend with Mammoth. You may discard this card from your hand to avoid an attack. If you do, draw 2 cards. You may destroy a starter in your hand or discard pile. Because of Booster Gold, we'll actually draw 3 cards. And I don't think we have any starters anymore. Nope, they are all destroyed. So that is no longer a thing. And we have to put a random card under Atrocitus, or under Booster Gold, until we beat Atrocitus. And that's going to be this one. That's Shapeshift. So, each player must destroy a superpower in his hand. We're going to destroy this kick right here in my hand, ending Kryptonite Meteor incredibly quickly. We'll keep going. Play Miss Martian. Put this aside and draw 5 new cards. As always, I really like Miss Martian. Strong card. Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's try and get Atrocitus this turn. Alright, Detonator's back on the board. Lady Vic's back on the board. That means 2, 3, 4 because we have these two out here. 5, and we can draw a card because of Molecular Vibration. 6, 7, 8 because of Booster Gold. 9, 10, we'll say Superpower? Ah, it's not. It's a hero. That's 10. We'll discard. You know what? We'll discard Molecular Vibration to draw a card. 11, 12, 13 power is enough to beat Atrocitus. We have 2 left over. I guess I could get Solstice, but I don't really see the point. I think we'll just stop there and go on to the next turn. Oh, wait, hold on. Oh, that's okay. I think I could have triggered House of Mystery and missed it. I'm not sure. Well, no defense cards here, so hopefully we don't lose Speed Force before we ever got to use it. We will get Shapeshift back, though. Oh, wait, this has to actually go on top of our deck. So I screwed that up. Hold on. 2, 3, 4, 5. And now, well, I do get a defense card now, so that's not so bad. So, our new crisis is Wave of Terror. At the start of your turn, discard all cards that share the lowest cost in your hand. Each player, this one actually is different. At the start of your turn, discard the top three cards of your deck. Remove this crisis if each of those cards has cost one or greater. All of ours do. We just need to survive this, I guess. Our new villain is Darkseid. We're going to defend against his attack with Magic Bracers. You may discard this card from your hand to avoid an attack, causing Booster Gold to draw a card. If you do, put an ongoing card from your discard pile into your hand. Where is he? Where is he? Molecular Vibration. Alright, new card comes out. First Wave of Terror makes us discard all the cards with the lowest cost in our hand. So that is both of these. Then we have to discard the top three cards of our deck and beat Wave of Terror if they all cost one or greater, which they do. So that is the end of Wave of Terror. Another really, really quick one. We really are moving quite quickly through this. We'll go with John Constantine revealing these two cards. We'll take Magician's Corset, leave this here. That does trigger House of Mystery to draw a card anyway. Then we'll play Magician's Corset to draw a card, get to one power. We can get a card from the destroyed pile. It's been a while since we've done that. Bumblebee's an option. I wish I could do Daughter of Trigon, but I cannot. Magic Bracers is okay. I mean, it's another defense card, which is really the benefit within this deck. Let's go for Bumblebee, because it doesn't take up any space in the deck once it's on the board, and if we need it, it's there. So again, we're only at one power so far. We can get a card of cost four or less from the lineup. We'll get Flight Wings, sure. Put it into our hands, right. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Anything here? Oh, Captain Atom triggered House of Mystery to draw a card. Oh, wait, no, something else did already. Sorry about that. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 power. We won't be using this. We do have to clear out some space, though, if we're going to get rid of Darkseid. So we'll get Azeroth, Metreon, Xynthos, and Magic. We have two left over. We won't be using that right now. That's a little better, at least. A little better. We're getting really close to the end already, it feels like. Alright, so, new card comes out. Reach Scarab, here goes 1, 2, 3, 4 power, because the Booster Gold also triggers House of Mystery to draw a card. 5, 6, 7. New ongoing card out here. 8, 9, we'll say Superpower. Ah, it's an equipment. 10, we can discard a card. Or we can destroy a card, I mean. Anything here we want to destroy? I don't really see anything worth destroying, so I don't think we will. That's 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. That's enough to beat him, so maybe, yeah, we'll beat him. We have one power left over. We won't be using it, though, I don't think. I think we'll just stop there, go to the next turn. We've got Miss Martian. That's good. We've got Flight for defense. We should be okay. It is Collapsing Parallel Worlds, which is actually okay. This is a great lineup for that. There's some really strong cards in there. Each player places all cards he buys or gains from the lineup under this card. Remove this crisis when there are 10 cards under this card. Then one player destroys his deck and discard pile. The cards under this crisis become his new deck. We'll get through that pretty easily, I think. This is a great example of what we want out there. Hades. Each player gains the top two cards of the main deck into the lineup. Gain weaknesses equal to the cost of one of those cards. We're going to use flight to defend against that. I can put a card from my discard pile on top of my deck. I put a card, just a single one, huh? A single card. Haven't got to use Speed Force yet, so why don't you put him there? Because, oh, I have to do this, but because of Booster Gold, I have to draw a card. Then we'll start our turn with Miss Martian, putting this aside to draw five cards. One, two, three, four, five. All right, that's one power. Two, three, four. House Mystery says draw a card. Five, draw another card. Look at these two. Six, seven. We'll leave that there. Eight, nine, hero. 10, 11, draw a card. Put this out there. 12, 13, 14, 15, draw two cards. 16, 17, 18, 19. 20, 21, and 22, 23 power. So that, yeah, that's a lot. That's a lot. We're going to get both of these. That's 10, so that's 13, 8, 8, and we'll go of this guy here, bring us down to 4, and this bringing us down to 0. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cards. That's pretty good. This has to go on top of our deck. Trying to get as many ongoing cards out there as possible. New card comes out. All right, let's look at the top card. We may discard it. We will. And then it is Bunker, revealing the top three cards here. One of each type into our hand. They're all different types. All right, one and draw a card. Two, three, four, five, let's say equipment. Ah. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, triggering this to draw a card. Won't be playing it, but 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 power. 19 power we'll use to get flight because it's a defense card, bring us down to 17. Minus six is 11, minus two is nine. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. I'm going to push it another turn. It's a few cards I don't really want to lose to this. New card coming out. All right. Ravager comes out. We can destroy a card, and we will. So that's one. This can enter the board. Four, five power, and that triggers House of Mystery to draw another card. Six. Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Definitely by Avatar of the Rot. So we have seven left over, and I have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. I only need one more card. What do I want to do? Because I'm going to lose a lot of really good cards. I could use this to put Cybernetic Enhancement on top of my deck. Get some stuff back. I'm going to lose Speed Force, though. Speed Force I can't get back from this. And that's my problem. But we'll get a lot of other stuff back. So, what will we keep? We'll keep two defense cards, a couple equipment. Let's do this. We're going to push it a few more turns. We're going to use a detonator to destroy a kick in here. And we're going to use another detonator to destroy what? Probably Quiver of Arrows. Flight Wings isn't doing anything for us, but we'll destroy Quiver of Arrows for now. Then I'm actually going to use these Molecular Vibrations to draw two cards. Okay. A bunch of wasted power, I know. I'm just trying to cycle through this deck, get all the ones I want to keep all in one if possible. So, just going to keep going. Really, I want to keep... What I really want to keep is Speed Force, because that is a 7-cost card we cannot get back once it's destroyed. So, it's kind of a mini game I'm playing right now to try and see if that's possible. It's obviously possible, it's just a case of, is it worth the effort? So Bumblebee can hit the board, which is good news. And then we can draw a card. Play this, that's, we'll say, 2 power. 3, 4, we can use magic on, we'll say Captain Atom here for 5, 6, destroying him. 7, 8 power, we're not going to buy anything though because we don't want to add anything to that lineup. We don't want to add anything to Collapsing Parallel Worlds because that will end the crisis. We don't want that right now. So Molecular Vibration is going to hit the board, so that's start. Then Bunker, revealing 3 cards. One of each type into our hand. Ms. Martian's out. Now it's John Constantine revealing these 2 cards. We'll take Mammoth into our hand. Because of John Constantine, we'll draw a card. We'll go with Magician's Corset, drawing another card. 1, 2, we'll say Superpower. It is. Then we're going to say 1, 2, Superpower. It is not. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I mean, we have a ton of power. That part is obvious. It's just not the ones we want right now. So what are we going to lose right now? We're going to lose Cybernetic Enhancement, unfortunately. Magician's Corset, John Constantine, Bunker. We can get those cards back. They all have ways of getting that back. Okay, new card comes out. Shapeshift. Then, you know, maybe not that. Maybe we'll use a Demonic Summoning. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and draw a card. 5, 6 and draw a card. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That triggers House of Mystery to draw another card. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Let's sacrifice a Molecular Vibration to draw a card. 18, 19. That's still not what we want. We'll keep going. Really don't want to lose this ultra powerful card. There it is. So let's see what we can do this turn. First off, Ravager. Or actually, we're going to use Miss Martian, put this hand aside, and draw 5 cards. Try basically one last hand here to clear out with any destruction means we have available to us to get rid of all the garbage in our hand, in our deck here, and be left with just the good ones. Well, that's not going to happen, but we'll do what we can. So there's that. There's Detonator hitting the board. Then John Constantine looking at these 2 cards. Oh, I don't want to destroy either one of them, but we'll put Demonic Influence into our hand. Leave Mammoth up here. No, other way around. Either way, we're drawing it because of House of Mystery, so we're still getting both. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We didn't get to do any destruction. Hold on. Wait, what am I doing? This goes on top of our deck. New card comes out. It is a villain. All right, see what we can do. Speed Force, 2 power, draw 2 cards. Three, four, five, six, draw a card because of this. Seven, draw a card. Did I? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. We should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We are one short. Okay. Perfect. So that's again 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Draw a card and then put an equipment or a defense card on top of my deck. That'll be this one. Bunker. Look at these three cards. Put one of each type into our hand. There we go. This one gets discarded. And again, we're at 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and we'll say hero. Yes. 2020, we'll save that. 20, we won't just bother destroying. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38 power is a lot. We'll go ahead and get Zookeeper, which will get added to this. In doing so, that becomes our new deck. And let's see what we lost. This is what we lost. Scarab is lost forever, unfortunately. But these, the rest of them are all things we can get back. Yeah, I don't see anything here we can't get back other than the Reach Scarab. So that's pretty good. So that crisis is beat. I know I delayed it a little bit, but that's okay. So we have 36 power right now, I believe. So with that, yes, we'll beat Hades. Bring us down to 24 power. Get Magic, bring us down to 9. Bowstaff, bringing us down to... Where was I? 38 minus 2 is 36. 24 minus 5 is 19. 16, there we go. With that 16, I think that's good. I think that's fine for this turn. So we're just going to discard this and get on to our next hand. We have a defense card, attack card. We have an ongoing defense, so we're in a good place. Let's see what happens. Our new crisis is Identity Crisis. Each player flips the superhero face down. Players cannot avoid the supervillain's first appearance attack. Each player must discard plus 6 power worth of cards from his hand, then flip their superhero face up. 3, 4, 5. I'm not in a place to do that. Hopefully we will pretty soon. Our new villain is Sinestro. Sinestro costs 3 more to defeat for each hero in the lineup. Each player puts all heroes from his hand into the lineup. That's Solstice here, so that's not a huge loss. So let's see what we can do. Well, first off, Avatar of the Ra is 3 power. With House of Mystery, though, we draw a card. We get a card from the destroyed pile. What's the most important one here? Probably something like Miss Martian, so we can kind of customize hands. Okay. 3 power. Draw a card. Put up to 2 superpowers from my discard pile into my hand. Maybe Magic here. Or you know what? Speed Force. Demonic Summoning. Yeah. Zookeeper will join up here. And then again, we're still at 3 power. 4, 5, and draw 2 cards. And then we're going to discard 2, 4, 6 power to get rid of Identity Crisis and get our hero back. Again, it's 3, 4, 5, 6 power total. We're going to use that. We're going to get Solstice and Arsenal, leaving us a 3 power. Hey, thanks for joining. Teen Titans and now Crisis 3 is hard to get right now, so I'm not terribly surprised. Good luck. I wish you good luck. I still have 3 power left over. I think what I want to do is discard Bumblebee to get to 4 power and Lady Vic to get the 5-6, using that to get Captain Atom. Okay. So far, ooh, come back. So far, post collapsing parallel worlds, we're doing okay. Well, hopefully that sticks that way. Nice. Crossovers are fun. We don't use them a lot in league play, but we will. I'm trying to use them more and more. But yeah, definitely get them. Play with your friends. It's awesome. Do you have any particular favorite crossovers you're looking for, or are any that you've enjoyed so far? So we're going to go ahead and try and take on Sinestro now. He costs 3 more to defeat for each hero, which is just Dick Grayson right now. Static is there. Let's start with Power of the Red, discarding 1, 2 cards and drawing 2 cards. Perfect. That was a really good move. Okay, 2 power, draw 2 cards. Because of House of Mystery, that's going to draw another card. Get a card from the destroyed pile. We'll get Magician's Corset, sure. Get a card from the destroyed pile. We'll get, let's get a defense card if it's here, like Mammoth. Nice. So we're still at 2 power. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, we'll say hero. It is. We can get a card of cost 4 or less from the lineup. Perfect. Oh, it goes into our hand. Sorry. 14, 15, we will discard this 2. Get 16 power, and we can destroy a card in our discard pile. We'll destroy Arsenal here. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. That's enough to beat Sinestro, leaving us with 7 power afterwards. Nothing out there I want to defeat, though, so we're good. Yeah, Birds of Prey is honestly one of my favorites. That's a really good choice. The rotation mechanic's a lot of fun. The characters are awesome. Yeah, my Women of Gotham City are definitely my favorite of the DC characters most of the time. So let's see what we got. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have a defense card, but it's not really necessary anymore. It's more for Booster Gold's bonus against this last villain. Rise of the Rot. At the start of your turn, gain a weakness unless you reveal one from your hand. Each player must discard a weakness and also remove this crisis if this weakness stack runs out. Okay, and it is Crisis Anti-Monitor. Whenever a hero is added to the lineup, each player puts a weakness from the stack on top of his deck. Crisis Anti-Monitor costs 1 more to defeat for each card in the lineup. Each player must defeat the villain to win the game. Now, because we're playing solo, this does add 2 cards per turn when Crisis Anti-Monitor is out. And Rise of the Rot is really a really bad one to have right now because we're going to want to destroy these weaknesses. So we do gain 1. A card does come out. Second card comes out. It's a hero, so we put a weakness on top of our deck. It's a bad set of circumstances. Well, we'll play Miss Martian, putting these cards aside and drawing 5 more. This could help. So, to beat, each player must discard a weakness card. Also remove this crisis if the weakness stack runs out. We're going to discard this weakness, getting rid of Rise of the Rot. So we beat our final crisis like that. We're going to then play Ravager to destroy a weakness. And we're going to discard Detonator to destroy the other weakness. So we are in line for some of a really good last turn here. All right, so 1, 2, 3 and draw a card. 4, and because of this, we'll draw another card. Five, six. There's no other equipment out here, unfortunately. Let's use magic on... Let's use it on Solstice here. So that's 7, and draw another card. This can come on out here. And then this is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. It's not quite enough. Oh, it does trigger House of Mystery. Put two superpowers from our discard pile into our hand. That's probably going to do it. Yeah. 13, 14, draw two cards. Reveal three cards. We're just about at the end here, I think. We'll take these two and discard this. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27. 27 power. That is more than enough to be Crisis Anti-Monitor. I mean, I really want to get John Constantine there and thin this deck out even more, but we didn't have to. We beat it real easily. That Rise of the Rot actually came at a very optimal time, because we had Ravager available to us, a couple detonators as well, and we cleared those weaknesses out very, very quick. So that was awesome. Yeah, great, great, great game. I'm really glad how this one went. And so, wented? Oh my god, I don't know. Why do we even bother talking? Alright, so I'm glad how this game went. So, this is again for the Solo Crisis League. We're on Season 7, Round 4. This is my third and final attempt for this round, and we're looking at the final round starting tomorrow. So, time is ticking. If you haven't finished all three of your games, now is the chance. So, if you enjoy the leagues, if you enjoy the videos, or whatever it is that brought you here tonight, I encourage you to maybe try supporting that. You can check it out by watching the videos or playing in the leagues. Appreciate it every single time, no matter what. So thank you. There's also the ability to check out the Etsy store if you want to hold something in your hands, like stickers, pins, or a game mat, all sorts of stuff. Check out the link below for that. And finally, there's the Patreon if you want to be a more regular member and get all sorts of rewards like mid-round results, special peeks at upcoming rounds, special members-only videos, and rounds between seasons. There's a lot of stuff. Might be something there for you. Check it out below. I have a few new members to thank today. We've got Matthew Noodles. Matthew Noodles has been a very involved member of the Solo Champions League for the last few seasons. So thank you for joining Matthew Noodles, and I'm glad you're enjoying yourself. If you're not sure what the Solo Champions League is, same as the Solo Crisis League, except we use Marvel Champions there. A lot of fun. And then we have Ortsiv. Ortsiv is the newest member. Again, they're part of the Solo Champions League, and I'm happy to have them around. I'm glad they're enjoying themselves, so thank you for joining, Ortsiv. This is all I've got for tonight. I've really enjoyed the combination of Teen Titans and Crisis 1. I think they just go well together. And I'm looking forward to the final round, where we'll be using Dark Knight's Metal in Crisis 3. That's all I've got for tonight, and you all have a good night.